Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Greetings and welcome. This is Zechariah1688 with another We Fail At. Once again, for the third time, the Kerbal Space Program. I'm telling you, I'm going to get an orbit. Let's go to the Space Center. Alright, from there we go to the Vehicle Assembly Building. Yeah, go away. Load spacecraft. Let's go back to the 602. Alright. Not really much has changed, a little bit of structural integrity. As you can see, I've added some bracers. Hopefully these bracers will work this time. If you noticed before in the last, there were bracers all the way down, and I realized that some of them had actually decided to be like this one here, and click, and then throw it over here. I decided to disconnect themselves, hence the reason whenever I decided to change the trajectory and get it into more of a orbit heading, so to speak, it went ahead and full kilted on me and decided to cut a flip and then explode right in my face like a Looney Tunes cartoon. So, alright, that should be the final touches, and here we go. This is an alpha. It's an alpha game, sorry. This game to allow some misgivings for it. Can't be too judgmental nor temperamental with it. Alright, here we go. Throttle up. Oh, that's a little bit high. A little bit high. Alright. There we go. Perfect throttle. Wings are going nuts because they're trying to stabilize even though it's on the ground. Alright, here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Controlled chaos. Alright, we're going up. Going up. I realize that the bandicam is right in the, overheating. We should be out of fuel. It's the same rocket as before. We should be out of fuel before they completely overheat. Alright, I do realize the bandicam is in the top of the screen, so you can't really see the actual altitude number that we're going. Hopefully we'll keep you up to date on most of it. At least the most significant numbers. But you can see the atmosphere bar, and that hopefully is enough. We're climbing. We're about to go through the first fuel canisters on our quad rocket booster system. Go ahead and max out that throttle. Try to get as high as we can, as fast as we can. Am I right? You know I'm right. Uh-oh. Yeah, I'll watch after that. It's low overheating. I'm going to leave that there for a little bit. Tell you what, I'll be right back as soon as we get to more interesting details like last time. Okay, we're back. Still going up. We are roughly 18,000 meters in the sky. As you can see, there's the curvature of the planet off in the distance. Very pretty, very pretty. We're on the last set of fuel canisters for this section of the rocket, and I'm going to turn off the guidance modules and steer just a little bit better to try to get into a orbiting trajectory. There we go. Turn on the RCS. Those little jet propels going off, trying to help me guide a little bit better. As soon as I get it. Come on. 30,000 meters in the sky. Nearly done with this. Alright, turn that on. Try to maintain this arc. Alright. Check how we're going there. Alright, see how that's growing? Yeah, the right time, too. Alright, see how that's growing? Hopefully, that circle will soon encompass the jettison. There we go. Yay! Alright, go back to this while that's going through its fuel canisters. Hopefully this arc will soon encompass the entire globe, and we'll be in orbit. It won't be much of a actual perfect elliptical orbit, but it'll be in orbit, right? That's something. That's better than us crashing and burning. Ooh, here we go. It's 51,000 meters. And almost done with this fuel canister. Let's see if we can get just a little bit more of an angle going on here. Try to hopefully increase that trajectory of orbit. Ooh, come on, come on, come on. That's mad dashing, mad dashing. It's increasing ever so slowly. I don't like this ever so slowly. Maybe if we do more of this. Radical maneuvers. Why not? We are the we at fails, correct? Alright. There we go. Well, that's not good. It's starting to descend rather rapidly. Crud. Well, that's about as close as I've gotten. Doing good so far. The line's still not increasing as much as I wanted. But let's go ahead and throttle up. Try to get as much use out of this as we possibly can. I don't care if you're overheating. Overheating be damned. Give me an orbit. It's getting close. I don't know why I decided to go this way around, but that's just how it launched me. Oh well. Maybe next time I'll learn my lesson, right? Oh no, that's getting kind of close. Kind of fast. Everybody, well, Bob and Jebediah seem to be having a good time. Bill's just freaking out. Maybe it's because he's got the window seat getting closer to the planet. I don't know. Let's go see. Where are the windows? Oh, they're both up here. They can't even see the ground. Maybe that's why he's freaking out. Alright. This is not going to end well. Let's try to make this a slow descent. Because, yeah, that's about as much as we're going to do. Alright. There we go. As you can see, I have two RCS canisters, so we should be good, and eight thrusters. Hence the reason for the tons of mobility going on there compared to the actual mass that this rocket is. Gotta love those SAS computers. They really know what they're doing. Alright, we're down to 18,800 meters above the surface. Looks like we're heading into Michigan with the 10,000 lakes. And here we go. Coming back into the atmosphere. All right. Go ahead and kill this and drop it, and then go ahead and drop that. Won't need it, and I'll be right back as soon as we land or get close to landing. Who knows, maybe we'll crash and burn this time too. Okay everyone, we're back, and I'm popping the parachute. My target is this little valley here by the lake. I figure it's kind of pretty, serene, give the cosmonauts here something to look at and enjoy while they wait for rescue, if rescue ever comes to them for failing so hard. I don't know, it did fail that hard. We started about right here, I guess. Feels like about right.